Hey guys, Teal'c here with another Overwatch hero overview. This time I'm looking at the DPS or assault hero named Pharah. Now, Pharah is not her real name, that is her call sign. Her real name is Fariha Amari. Now, she is an Egyptian, and she is part of a long line of decorated soldiers. It's kind of in the family history to be a part of the decorated soldiers and be kind of a protective force for good out there in the world. That's what Fariha does, and that is what her family has done. As a child, she always dreamed of joining Overwatch because her mother was a part of Overwatch and she herself wanted to be a part of Overwatch. However, unfortunately, even though she continued to rise in the ranks, she enlisted in the Egyptian army. She rose in the ranks, and people loved her. She was one of the favorite leaders out there in the army. Overwatch ended up disbanding and falling apart, and this was, kind of a big disappointment for Fariha. So, instead of joining Overwatch, what she ended up doing was joining, the Helix Security International, which was basically a private security firm that was in charge of protecting one of the Omnic installations that was down there in Egypt. And so, as such, that is what she did. However, she was very disappointed and kind of still mourns the loss of Overwatches and really kind of yearns for that time in which she'll be able to join something like Overwatch and be a part of that. Now, the suit she is wearing is called the Raptor Mark IV, and it comes from that top secret facility. And it's one of the most powerful combat units designed in the world. And it's completely known for its rapid mobility and devastating firepower. And that is where she gained the call sign Pharah. And she continues to protect that AI installation until she's able to, possibly, maybe in the future, if it's possible, join Overwatch and follow in the footsteps of her mother. So, welcome to Pharah. In my opinion, one of the strongest heroes in the game, and it's mostly because of her air mobility. And if you understand how to use her kit, you can be a real nuisance to the enemy team. So her first ability is just a straight up rocket launcher that does plenty of damage. It is AoE, it will do lots of damage. Let's see how much damage I can do across the map. Two shots even across the map. So, unlike other heroes that may lose some damage with the long range distance, Pharah's rockets do not, and it's just a lot of damage. It's AoE, so I can fire it in between, and you can see how it does damage to both. So, if you're not careful, even the AoE will get you. Though, I will say there is a massive difference between actually getting hit with one of these rockets and then just getting hit with the AoE. Now, her entire kit revolves around her ability to fly. So her first ability is like it's a jump jet. It's called jump jet, and it's the ability to just soar up into the air. And I can go ahead and launch myself up here, and then I can fly. If you press the space bar, her passive is that if you press the space bar while you're in the air, you can fly. Now, you can only fly as long as that fuel is there, and the fuel comes back really quickly. As you saw, I was able to kind of glide down because the fuel continually respawned as I continue to hold the space bar down, or whatever your jump button may be. But it's something that you need to take note of with Pharah, is that she's able to deal a lot of, to be a nuisance by flying around the battlefield like that. And if you understand her kit, which we will get to in a second, she can be even more powerful. Now, she has an ability called Concussive Blast, and she fires basically another rocket that will launch players. So I'm gonna go ahead and use it. And he didn't move much because these training targets are right in the way, but we will try it on one of these others. Somewhat of a decent cooldown. So I need to come out in the open. I don't want I don't want to send him flying inside the room.
Clearing the area.
So you saw what it did there. Now, what's really potent about Pharah is going to be the ability to launch yourself with your own concussive blast and then shoot forward. Because the concussive blast will actually move you. So, we're gonna come over here. And we're gonna launch ourselves. And then launch up into the sky and move around. This can change your positioning quite quickly. It doesn't do damage to you. But it allows that mobility through the air that's really aggravating. And when you're trying to figure out where Pharah is and she's just launching rockets down here, it becomes very difficult to deal with. Especially since she can just stay in the air and she can find some areas of the map that most people can't reach. So most of the areas that you're not used to looking for people, Pharah's gonna find them. And then you're gonna have trouble dealing with Pharah. And that's going to be irritating. Now, do note that her own rockets will do damage to you, as you see there. Now, I will say that the burst from Concussive Blast is not the greatest, but it's still available for you to use. So, manipulating her kit to the best of your ability and finding areas that people cannot do anything about are something that you should pay attention to. Now, Pharah has one of those ultimates that you should be afraid of, just like Genji or Hanzo, basically, or McCree even. Basically, if you hear her and it'll be Justice Reigns from above, you want to watch out where she is and be careful of her. So I'm going to go ahead and launch over here.
Justice Reigns from above.
And as you can see, you basically just launch rockets continually from the sky. Now, be careful, because if there's a Widowmaker or a sniper, you're really vulnerable when you're firing off those rockets. So you want to be really careful where you put your placement when doing that. You don't want to be just out in the open in the middle firing out here where everyone can see you and everyone can fire at you, because I guarantee you, you'll die really quickly if you, Pharah, are not focusing the few people that are playing. But if you are focusing, if you've caught them all bottled up, it ends up being advantageous. But if not, someone can pick you off very quickly. And that is the one detriment to her ultimate ability, is that she's very, very vulnerable when she's up in the air like that. Where I was, which was in the middle right here, I could have gotten picked off by anyone. Let's say it's someone up here, because I was aiming down there. Someone could have just picked me off real easily down here. And that's the one thing you have to watch out for Pharah's ultimate. But really, where she excels is her aerial mobility. And able to move around the map and really throw people around the map with that concussive blast. Excuse me. I know I got tossed around one time because of that concussive blast, and it was really irritating. See ya. Dead. So, something you need to be careful of. She can be anywhere on the map. She is the one hero in which you have to check the most oddball spaces for where Pharah could be, because she can fly anywhere, and that's what makes her so powerful. It's not just the rockets, which really do... The damage really does add up over time with those rockets. It does add up over time. And if you're not careful, you'll find yourself dead really quickly.
Double kill.
So, I'll show you one more time before I go. The ultimate... Whoops. I jumped right into the worst spot there. I can't even get high enough to be, to actually get there in time. To get high enough in the air, I should say. Do note that just flying up is not really useful. As you can see, you want to be able to launch yourself up before setting up for actually killing someone. I was trying to aim for this bot right here. Whew. Remember, rockets up close do hurt. So, that is everything with Pharah. She's very enjoyable, and you're going to have a frustrating time if you don't understand that with her you have to look everywhere and be careful of where she is at all times. And that, you know, if you're sitting in a corner pocket waiting to see where she may, like if you're poking your head out of this door right here wondering where she may be, please do know that she could basically be flying through the air and then launching down at you when you don't even realize it while you're sticking your nose out of the door. So you have to be careful with Vera in that regard. Otherwise, that is everything regarding Pharah. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed Overwatch, and I will see you guys later. Tearless out.